Good morning, my beautiful, beautiful Facebook family. Just wanted to say something this morning to my young comrades in the Lord, those that are babies in the Lord. Just want you to know that God is not what you see in the churches. He is not what you see in the attitudes of people that profess to be saved. And many of them are preaching, they are prophesying, they're doing all these things, but they have wickedness in their hearts. I want God to preserve your innocence as he did mine up until this very day. I never realized that people were wicked like that, that were in churches. I had to pull away in order for me to see the heart of men. But God warned us, and I'm going to read a scripture to you on this morning. This is my last insert for this week. And I pray that this is going to be effective for you and that you are going to be able to be moved and continue on in the faith because of this prayer. I want you to know that the wicked is not in the world as much as it is in the church, because it was the church that killed Jesus Christ. I'm going to do a scripture from 10, the 10th chapter. I'm going to start at the second verse. But I want you to know that God is not what you see. So your pursuit for the Lord, your pursuit for him is going to be, I want you to understand this, it's going to be a personal relationship. And I'm not saying that you don't need to go to church, because Jesus utilized the church to get him to the cross, okay? The church helped him get to the cross. And all of us are not chosen to die as some of us, many of us that have been called to collect the harvest. We have been chosen to die. We have been chosen to come to a death place. And even as Jesus laid on the cross and felt as if he was forsaken by God, it does feel as if you are forsaken when you are chosen to collect the harvest. But I want to tell you today to be encouraged, to be encouraged. I love this Jason Nelson, because he said forever is a long time, and that's how long God is going to love us. He's going to love us forever. It doesn't matter about your struggle, but I want you to know that if you made a commitment to the Lord, you need to be committed to it. Don't allow what you see in churches, what you see in others, to discourage your walk in God. This is a personal relationship with him, okay? And so I want you to know that when you pray and when you ask him to forgive you for your sins, he will do that. And Yahushua, Jesus Christ, is the mediator between God and man. He knew that it was going to be a struggle. Come on, he knew the cup that he had to drink from, and he still asked God to remove it. He understood that he had to die on the cross, but he still felt forsaken. I just want you to know that when you have to come through the death process, and sometimes it seems that we are forsaken, but we are not forsaken. We are not forsaken. We are not forsaken. I just want you to know that. Oh, hallelujah. And while the wicked walk in their arrogance, while the wicked walk in their envy, while the wicked walk in their jealousy and prophesy and preach the gospel of Jesus Christ with the wickedness in their hearts, God said he went through it first. His apostles went through it first. And we too must suffer what they have suffered. He said we're going to be hated of all men. Luke, the 10th chapter in the second verse, say that the harvest is truly great, but the laborers are few. Many have not labored to enter into the spiritual planes of God. Oh, no. They've entered into the churches. They've entered into the storefronts. They've entered into the cathedrals, but they have not entered into the spiritual domain of God. They have not labored, because when you are born out of one life, the other life must come into a place of collapse. Okay. And so there are many that don't realize that the laborer are not those that go out and preach the gospel and prophesy with wickedness in their heart, but the laborers are those that give birth to the Spirit of God, the love of God for the flock of God. And the Bible says that the harvest was ripe, that people are ready to receive our God. They're ready to receive our Lord. But the laborers, those that labor to enter into his spirit, to enter into his heart, they're few. It ain't that many, okay? So go ye your way. Going to the next verse, the third verse. Behold, I send you forth as lambs. Oh yeah, you have an innocence. We have an innocence. Oh yeah, I didn't know until I stepped back
looked and I took a look. Oh yeah, we have an innocence, and we understand that people, when they get saved, it doesn't necessarily, they give their lives, don't necessarily mean that they give their lives over to God completely. Because if you're still operating out of the nature in the fruits of the flesh, if you're still operating out of the wickedness in the end, and Satan will exalt you. He will exalt you with all of these cruelties in your heart. He will exalt you with all of these cruelties in your heart. But let me tell you something. This is not the representatives of the Lord, because he is the God of love. He is the essence and the totality of love. And so we understand that we are sent forth in the midst of wolves, those that are preaching the gospel, those that are on platform, those that look to be successful, but they are wolves because they are out, they are greedy dogs. They are looking to feed their bellies. They care nothing for the flock. They care nothing for their sisters and brothers except to kill them. But their hands were routed by God. God said, I made vessels of righteousness and unrighteousness. And so the unrighteous vessel is there to help the righteous vessel to be developed. It is there to bring the righteous vessel to its rightful place in the heavens. Also, don't be discouraged on this morning. Understand that Daniel prayed, and when he prayed, he thought that God did not hear him. But the angels came and they said, Daniel, we heard you. We heard you the first time you prayed, but war took place in the heavenly places. So God is warring on our behalf. He's warring for us. He's warring for us. But if we ask to see the glory of God, we must know that there is a crushing in the press. There is a crushing of the outer man. Two entities cannot abide in the same space at the same time. There must be a collapse of one house in order for the other house to be manifested. And so, God, I thank you. Let's go into prayer on this morning. I'm excited for you. I'm excited for you. You're a baby. And God wants you to know you got to be encouraged. God's representatives look like love. They look like the fruit of the Spirit. They act like the fruit of the Spirit. It's not fake. It doesn't change, because it is the very substance of God that's been born in man. And so we're looking for the manifested sons and daughters of Yah, those that will walk according to the word, not by speech, but by articulation that is inundated in life, in the lifestyle, in the lifestyle. I'm ashamed. But when there is a collapse taking place, oh, we cry out. We cry out to God. As cry out to him, there is a shedding that takes place. When we are looking to do it his way, when we are looking to go in the way of the kingdom, there is a collapse taking place, a shedding of the old man in the name of Jesus. And those that never shedded the old man, they are snakes, they are wolves, they are conniving, they are wicked in their hearts. They care nothing for the flock except for what they can feed their belly. But God wants you to know, just like Jason Nelson is saying here, he loves you, and he gonna love you forever. He gonna love you forever. Come on, the grave lost its power. Let's go into prayer. Oh, hallelujah. God bless you. Hallelujah. Forever. God, I give you glory this morning. I thank you for my sisters and brothers. I thank you for these babies that have accepted you as their Lord and Savior. God, don't let them be discouraged by what they see. Let them understand that you hear them and that you are with them, even in the struggle. Cover them. Cover them with your presence. Cover them with your spirit. Cover them, or mashe, and encourage them. Give them the power to overcome the adversity. Give them the power to overcome what they see. Give us the power, God, understanding that we are not walking by what we see. We are not walking by what we feel, but we are walking by what we understand is true. Oh, God, in the name of Jesus, God, let your divine will be done. Let it be done in the lives of those that have said yes to your will, yes to your purpose, yes to your way, in spite of the opposing forces of hell. My shame. God, we love you on today because you are the only one that can bring us through, oh God. That can transform us, oh God. You said, oh God, in the name of Jesus, that Lord God, that when we cry out to you, that you hear our cry, oh God. And so, God, I pray on this morning. I pray, Lord God, that no one, Lord God, will stand between us and the altar and every spirit, Lord God, that have come to hinder the prayers of the righteous, that you will eradicate it in the name of Jesus. Let them know that you are our Abba Yah, you are our Abba Father, and no weapon formed against us shall prosper, but it must be formed in order for us to move into your divine will. God, there is nobody greater than you, because you are the great I am. You are the great I am. You are the Lord of Lords. You are King of Kings, and we give glory on this morning. God, cover their children. Let there be no backlash because of their progression. Let there be, oh God, no repercussion because they chose you. But put, Lord God, your angels around their babies. Put your angels around their resources. Put your angels around their jobs. Put your angels around them. Oh, not my shame. Our aunts, our uncles, our children, oh God, our nieces and our nephews, our sisters and our brothers, angels of the living God, we call you forth and we ask you to go now and to attach yourself all around and about our families as we birth this thing out in the name of Jesus and labor to enter into his kingdom. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, he came mana, inamayana na na ona. Who can separate us from your love, God? Nothing can separate us from your love. Principality, spiritual rulers of the darkness, nothing can separate us from your love. Because you are born in us, oh God. Thank you, Lord God, for leading us, for directing us, for guiding us, oh God. And we give you the glory on today. Even that atmospheres will be changed because you're being born in us. And God, I ask you, Lord God, to continue to lead these babies. Continue to, Lord God, encourage these babies. Empower them to get the victory. Empower them to get the victory. In the name of Jesus, send your anointing. Send your fire upon every altar that has been erected against our household. Send your anointing. Send the fire to destroy every yoke of the enemy, that we may move forth without resistance. In the name of Yeshua, in the name of Yeshua, the Holy One of Israel. And God, we're going to love you forever, because forever is being born on the inside of us. Eternal life is being born on the inside of us. We glorify you. We magnify you. We give you all the glory on this morning, because no weapon. We laugh at the enemy because he thinks that he's winning, because he cannot win towards you. Because you've already won the victory. You've already won the victory. Ah, my shade. All it takes is faith to move in, faith to push out, faith to keep moving. Ah, my shade. In the name of Jesus, oh God, we understand that we are not so important, that we don't have to go through what you went through. You say those that suffer with you shall reign with you. And God, we're suffering with you on today. We're surrendering to you on today. Oh God, help us to love like you love. Help us to move like you move. Help us to produce what you produce in the name of Yeshua. Oh, hallelujah. Hey, God. God, we love you. We love you. We love you. Oh, God, because you're by us. Oh, yeah, we know that you're on our side, because you are on the side of the righteous. Oh, God, no witch, no warlock. Witches are those that rebel against your word, not tradition, that rebel against your truth, not indoctrinated, the indoctrinations of man, that rebel against your word, your word, your word. Oh, God, not a ruler of the temple, but your word. You said those that submit to your counsel, which is the word of God, that you will write your word in our minds and in our hearts, and nothing by any means to be able to be opposed to who you are in us, because you are the great I am, and nothing in this world is greater than you. And we thank you on today for empowering us to get the victory. Amashe inamayana ananama unamayana heke. Oh God. Oh, hallelujah. So thank you, Lord God. Thank thank you for the victory. That's today's prayer. We gonna thank him. Because even though it don't look like it's being done, it's done already. There's war going on in the heavenlies on your behalf, on my behalf. War is taking place in the heavenly places just for you, just for me. Hanamashe. Thank you, Jesus, for your faithfulness. Thank you, Hamashe. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you for our children being saved. Thank you for our aunties being saved. Thank you for our uncles being saved. Thank you for breaking, Lord God, the drug addiction over the household. God, thank you for tearing down every wicked altar that was, Lord God, erected in the bloodline. Thank you. We thank you, Lord God, that just as you, Lord God, inundated, oh God, just as you inundated Ruth into the bloodline of Yahshua Jesus Christ, you inundated us into the bloodline, that our bloodline will be curved, that our bloodline and we'll move straight into you in the name of Yeshua. God, we raise you up on today in the face of our enemy. We lift you up. We praise you in the face of our enemy because you are a forever always God. You are the forever always God. And you gave us eternal life. And we live out of the life that is being born in us as we labor to enter in. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you for those that are here. Thank you. Let your anointing be upon them. Let your anointing, send your anointing, send your anointing to break every yoke. Send your fire to destroy every evil altar. Send your fire upon every wicked altar that have been risen up against the people of Yah. Ha, my share, na, 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 my honor. You, Lord, will get the glory. You're going to get the glory, Lord. Oh, you're going to get the glory because it's already written in the heavenly places. We're manifesting, Lord, what you've already accomplished in the heavenly places. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done in earth, in these earthen vessels, as you've already established it in the heavenly places. We come into agreement on this morning. Ah, yes, God. And we understand, oh God, that prayer is just not 20 minutes, but it is communion with you. And that we have to break down the walls, oh God, the walls of our flesh, that we might enter in our prayer closet. Oh God, we got to break down the wall of flesh because you have already gave us a wall in a petition that we can go in and we can sup with you. We can do the supplication. Oh yeah, God. Oh God, so we're coming on this morning asking you, God, do it for him. Everything that is on your altar, oh God, that is in alignment with your will. Oh God, we don't pray against your will. We don't pray against your word because we know that that's witchcraft, but we pray in alignment with what you already accomplished in the heavenly places. Help us, ah, my share, my eye, to come into alignment with what you already done. Help us in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Yahshua. Hallelujah. So you give him praise on today, my friends, my beautiful Facebook family. Give him praise on today because he's going to love you forever. Don't be discouraged. Don't be discouraged. He said he's sending you forth in the midst of wolves. You're going in the midst of wolves. Although you love them, and those that say that they love them too, they're wolves because they're trying to kill the righteous. They're wolves preaching the gospel because they're hating on the righteous. They're wolves. Ha, my shade. But he's sending you forth with divine protection because you got something to accomplish on behalf of heaven. Steadfast. Be steadfast. Be steadfast. Unmoved. Unmoved. Ha, my shake. Who am I? Yeah, coming on. Na, 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 my owner. Satan is defeated and those that follow him. For the fishes in the load, they too are the defeated. It don't look like it, but they are defeated because they chose now. We choose forever. Hamashe, in the name of Jesus. And God, we glorify you this morning. And we thank you for being what you are to us, which is our Savior, our King, our Lord. Hallelujah. So as you go into your work, your place of employment on today, as you drive down the street in your car, praise the Lord for whatever you're going through. Come on through. Come on through it so his glory can be revealed in you. Come on through it. Ah, my shay, we cannot judge anything before the time. Don't judge anything by the outward appearance, because it's all about the outward appearance with Satan. But come on through this thing, because he's with you. Well, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on with it. Come on, come on, come on. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. You got to come on through, come on through, come on through. Babies, God heard you when you first called him. He heard us when we first called him. God is not what you see. If you don't see it in alignment with the word, it's not God. If they're trying to kill you, they've been put in order by God. Nobody can do anything that God has not permitted. All things are already accomplished. We are just manifesting what has already been done in the heavenly places. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. We're coming into agreement with heaven. We're coming into agreement with what he's already said. We're coming into agreement with what he's written in our minds and in our hearts. We're coming into agreement with this, saints. We're coming into agreement with this, new babies. And for you that choose to love him, I ask God to give you the grace to make it to him. Grace, oh Hamashe. Grace, oh hallelujah. The strength to make it to him. Amashe. He loves you with an everlasting love. And Yahashua is interceding for you. He's interceding for us. Oh, hallelujah. So you go praising God. You go praising God. You go praising God. You hear what I'm telling you? Go praising God. Oh, hallelujah. I love him on today, you guys. He is the best thing that has ever happened to me. And if you knew like I knew, you would choose him forever. Come on, let's worship him a little bit. Let's worship him. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Forever is for always. Forever is for always. I love him on today, and I love you. I love even the enemy. And I ask God to save and deliver them. Deliver them from their evil. Deliver them from their hatred. Deliver them from their envy. Deliver them, oh God. I bless them. I do not curse them. We will not become the mirror of who they are, but we will reflect who he is in us. Oh God, we love you. We love you. Oh, hallelujah. Come on, let's praise him. I'm just waiting for my part, you guys. Oh, hallelujah. I've enjoyed you this week. This is the last time that I will be coming up with insertion of prayers. I just want you to know the real prayer takes about an hour to get into, because you have to bust through the walls of the flesh. You have to bust through the walls. Real prayer. Not to say that my prayers or your prayers are not immediately answered. I know most of the time when I pray, I see instant results for people, but not myself. And so I don't pray too much for myself. I pray for others. And I think that's God getting our eyes off of us and putting our eyes on others. Oh, hallelujah. So I just want you to know that forever is for always. And he's going to love us. He's going to love us, you guys, forever. In spite of your falls, get back up. Babies fall. Brush your knee off, or if you have a good parent in the Lord, let them brush your knee off. And when I say parent, that means they are a stepfather or a stepmother. They are a step up to the truth of God. God is our true father, and he put stepfathers like Joseph in place to lead us to him alone, that we might obey what he's already accomplished. Come on, let's sing, you guys. And that's how long I love you. That's how long I love you, forever. Forever is a long time. I love him. That's how long I love you. That's how long I love you, forever. Oh God, I love you. Oh hallelujah, on my shot. I love you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Forever. I love you. Hallelujah. Go praising him, you guys. Go praising him. Praise him in your car this morning. Praise him on your workplace. Praise him while you're putting your clothes on. Praise him. Praise him. I love you. Bye-bye, you guys. I love you with an everlasting love. Have a beautiful and blessed weekend. Hallelujah.